Jovi rocks on occasion. And I walk these streets with a six string on my back. Life keeps. Come on. Cause I might not make it back. Been everywhere.
Oh, yeah.
I'm standing tall. I've seen a million faces. And I rock them all. Cause I'm a cowboy. On a steel horse I ride. I'm wanted.
Wanted.
Dead or alive. Dead or alive. Dead or alive.
Spring in upstate New York. Dad was on a river road hunt. We crashed into the bungalow colony with a ping pong table.
Yeah, you
disappeared. I came back, you were gone. You shipped me off to Bobby's for a couple months. We found you. We were lost on a hunt or something. That's what he told you,
right?
Sorry, that's what you told me? Truth is, I lost the food when your dad left the boys in the car. I didn't get hungry, so I tried taking a five-finger discount at the local market and got busted. I wasn't on a hunt. They sent me to a boys' home.
A boys' home? Like a reform school?
Yeah, more or less. It was a farm, and the guy who ran it, Sonny, he looked after me.
And does Sonny know what we do?
Yeah. He's good people. I gave him the number to the back phone, and sounds like he's got something in our wheelhouse. So, hey, you gonna be cool to do this, or are you too tired?
No, I'm just, I'll be fine.
And everybody's okay with heading out to the casket.
I am everybody.
Yeah. Right. Just go.
Baby, baby, baby.
Hey.
Yep.
Next time you hear me say that our family is messed up, remind me that we could be psycho dope.
Yeah, that's true enough. She must have had a good reason.
A good reason? A good reason for working with those ass clowns?
Look, I hear you, all right? But at the end of the day, she's family. We owe it to her to at least...
Right, one screw. I need a drink. No, I need drinks, plural. And this whole peacemaker shtick that you've been running, first with Cass, now with Mom, it's getting old, man.
What's that supposed to mean?
You're always playing in the middle. For once, why don't you pick a side?
Jack was our way over there, obviously, so with him gone.
Okay, well, Jack's been gone before. We found him once. We can find him again.
He didn't run away. He is literally in an alternate reality.
Okay, so we'll just come up with a plan. Okay, set it yourself. We should keep our heads down and move.
You said it.
That was right. Yeah. So, you read, do your same thing.
Yeah.
We should probably get Cass in at some point.
We'll fill him in when he calls. He checks in every day.
I can't stop thinking about Mom.
Yeah.
I can't stop thinking. Most people, it's hope and faith, right? That's all they have, but we know the truth. We know God is real. We know angels are real, too.
God writes paperback books in his underwear, okay? And angels are dicks.
But they're real, right? We know that Mom's not sitting on a cloud playing a harp. She's in a good place. Or she's in a great place. She's with Dad.
You know what else? There wasn't enough left of her to even try to bring her back.
Chinese treasures. It's a pearl that grants wishes. Sort of. Well, technically, it's supposed to give you what your heart desires.
That would be Michael out of my freaking head.
Exactly.
So you're telling me that the answer to all of our problems is sitting right outside?
Thank you.
make sure that you're still with me on this thing. You're gonna see it through to the end.
You gave my word, didn't I?
Okay, all right. It's, you know, after what you said last night, I don't need you and Mom coming up with some way to stop me.
You know, Mom hates this. I hate this.
I know.
And Cass and Jack, you haven't even told them.
Okay, well, yeah, that's because I'm not good with the whole big goodbyes, all right? I don't need to get shaky on this thing.
Wouldn't be the worst thing.
You know what Michael wants to do. You know that this will stop it, and you know that there's no other way. So just put the end of this trip out of your head, okay? Fill up holy oil, right?
For what?
We're gonna have to hit it with everything we got.
I'm just saying, look, with everything that's happened, I'm obviously spun out also, but we need a plan.
Yeah. Kill him, okay? That's the plan. But right now, all that matters is finding him and ending him before he hurts anybody else. Once we do that, we'll figure everything else out.
What about Cass?
You know he is.
exactly track Dagon, so I don't think I definitely trying to figure out how much time we have before.
Little loose kebabs?
Yeah. Okay, so we know Kelly got pregnant sometime in early December, according to the lore. Nephilim don't need 9 months to get to full term, so I think she will be giving birth around May 18th, which means...
It'll listen a month to find her.
Yeah, exactly, no idea why she's doing.
Okay, but even if we do find her, what then?
Oh.
Good news, there's nothing on Angel Radio and Heaven's still in lockdown, so Rogue Angel is out.
Bad news? Gas is chumming it up with Crowley. They're hunting Lucifer together.
That's right. One's an angel, one's a demon, and apparently they solve crimes.
Are they having luck?
Kind of. So Lucifer, Lord of Evil, Angel of Light, is now the master of Butt Rock. He jumped into Vince Vicente.
The rock star?
The douchebag. The guy used to roll a purple hair down to his butt and a spiked cotton piece.
It was the 80s.
What?
It was the 80s.
Somebody else, no thanks, you can't take it. Hey, listen, I'm not happy about this, okay? It's a tough job.
It's supposed to be tough, Dean. We're supposed to struggle with this. That's the whole point.
What's everybody's?
A clear conscience, for one.
You look at that.
What the hell's happened to you?
What?
You might kill an innocent man, and you don't even care. You don't act like yourself anymore, Dean. Hell, you know what? You're acting like one of those things out there.
Thanks, Carlos. Listen, you get track of any other demon activity, give me a holler, right? Appreciate it.
Anything?
Yeah, a dozen demon-related cases, people without souls acting out.
But no sign of Abaddon.
Right, that's why she's vanished.
Just gotta keep digging.
Yeah.
Let's get to work.
fairness, we didn't decide. You did, okay?
I decided that a hockey stick that can kill anything might come in handy. So, soon.
How many times have we been around this block? Magic that powerful comes at a price. And right now, we don't know what that price is.
I'm fan-friggin-tastic.
And I'm glad, honestly. I'm not saying we bury the thing. I'm saying we just save it for when we really need it. Crowley, Metatron, the big boss fights. You don't have to have it with you all the time, right? You just leave it. Please. Thank you. Out.
Operative phrase.
Sorry.
Sorry. Sorry, are you?
Sorry that
you plan to keep Donatello alive, but when it comes to you, you're just throwing the towel? Or are you sorry that after all these years, our entire lives, after I've looked up to you, after I've learned from you, I've copied you, I've followed you to hell and back? Are you sorry that all of that, it means nothing?
Who's saying that?
You. You tell me I have to kill you. You're telling me that I have to just throw away everything we stand for. Throw away faith. Throw away family. We're the guys who saved the world. We don't just check out of it.
Sam, I have tried everything.
I got one card left to play. And I have to play.
You've one card today.
But we'll find another tomorrow. But if you quit on us today, there will be no tomorrow. You tell me you don't know what else to do. I don't either, Dean. Not yet. What we're doing now, it's wrong. It's quitting. I mean, look what just happened. Donatello never quit fighting, so we could help him because he never gave up. I believe in us.
Let's go home.
What?
Let's go home. Maybe Billy's wrong. Maybe. But I do believe in us. I believe in all of us. And I'll keep believing until I can. Until there's absolutely no other way. But when that day comes, if that day comes, Sammy, you have to take it for what it is. The end. And you have to promise me that you'll do then what you can't do now. And that's let me go. And put me in that box. You too.
I believe him.
Great. So do I. But Friar Tuck over there, we don't owe him anything. Besides, he sucker punched you.
And I get why. I mean, if somebody, somebody stole the Impala,
what would you do? Murder. I'd murder them all.
Right. Well, my point being, I don't want a dick like Green Street or Scarpani to win. Not this time.
There'd be torture first. It'd be like a lot of torture, and then it would end up with death. I can't have it, nobody can.
Were you even listening to what I was saying? Scarpani and Green Street? One lesson.